Yesterday we discussed drop shipment, back-to-back order, then internal sales orders, IR/ISO, internal requisition and internal sales order. These are very important questions. What is drop shipment? Drop shipment, customer approaches for an item to the organization, whereas organization which is using Oracle application, where we are, let us say I am the sales guy, I receive the order from the customer in the form of purchase order from the customer. I am the supplier to the customer, so I have the purchase order. Now against that purchase order, I am going to create a sales order. That sales order in which we have the headers, that is customer information, bill to ship to, terms and conditions, then what is the order type, price list and everything. Then in the lines we have the item, whereas quantity, price, everything, ship to location, but source type is external. Because whatever the item you entered in the sales order, that's what we are not maintaining any stock in the inventory. So whenever order comes for an item for which we are not maintaining the stock, we have to approach supplier. So we have to approach third party. That third party is nothing but a supplier. When we approach supplier, that means anytime if you are approaching supplier, customer approached to his supplier, that is nothing but organization. So he brought the purchase order. Similarly, we are approaching supplier, again you have to raise purchase order. That purchase order has to be sent to supplier saying that this is the ship to location, ship the item directly to the customer. Then supplier ships the item to the customer. As we have the PO with respect to supplier, we will have AP invoice. Already we have sales order with respect to customer. Customer pays to the our organization, that's it, because we have the sales order with respect to customer. Customer is having no relation with the our supplier, because we have the PO with supplier, so we are going to pay AP payment. AP invoice will be raised. AP invoice will be, account payables invoice will be raised. So in this process, customer approaches organization, organization approaches third party, we will request third party to ship the item directly to the customer, which is nothing but drop shipment, where we have the source type as external for that particular item. Here the important thing is what documents you are going to. With customer we are going to have sales order, so your invoice will be there with respect to the customer. We have the PO with respect to supplier, so you will have AP invoice with respect to the supplier. That's it. That is what drop shipment. We have seen the different statuses of the lines of the sales order whenever you book the order with the source type of external, that is awaiting receipt. In case it is not awaiting receipt, it is booked. Run the workflow background engine with the parameters, process deferred, yes, process timeout, no. Next one, back to back order. What is back to back order? Customer approaches for an item to the organization. Organization which is using Oracle application, where I am the sales guy, I receive the order from the customer in the form of PO. Against that PO, we are going to raise the SO as similar to drop shipment, but the source type in the shipping tab will be internal, not external. When it is internal, we are going to ship the item from our inventory. But if you look for the quantity, there is no quantity of the item. Then what you will do? You will approach third party again, supplier, but you will receive the item as a normal purchasing, like you raise the purchase order with respect to supplier, receive the item into your stock. From your stock, let us ship the item to the customer, ship to location. That's it, which is nothing but back-to-back order. Here also, you have the sales order with respect to the customer, so you are going to have account receivables invoice with respect to the customer. Whereas you have the PO with supplier, so you are going to have AP invoice again there is no change at all in the documentation. But the source type is internal and external in back-to-back order and drop shipment order respectively. Coming to ISO, internal requisition, we have our organization where Oracle application has been used. Now, in this organization, I am the sales guy. Let us say I am using Oracle application. Now, I have to ship the item to my another organization. I am working for one company. The same company is having another branch at different location. For example, Tata Motors having the branch at Hyderabad and Gujarat, whereas Gujarat is the manufacturing plant, Hyderabad is distribution center. But to have the Tata Nano car at Hyderabad, I have to get the item from Gujarat. So I am working in Hyderabad, let us say. So I will raise requisition. What kind of internal? Why? Because I am getting from Gujarat Tata Motor organization. I am not getting from BMW. I am getting from same group of the company. Okay. So now I raise requisition. What kind of internal requisition? Not purchase requisition. So internal requisition has been approved. Then you have to create internal orders, which creates the data in the interface tables of Gujarat organization. So we have IR, internal requisition, which has been approved. After approval, you have to run create internal orders, which will create the data in the interface tables of Gujarat organization. In Gujarat, they have to import the order. Create internal order from Hyderabad, you are going to create internal order. That internal order will be appearing in Gujarat. So Gujarat people should import. Gujarat people should import the lines so that they can see the internal orders which have been created against the internal requisition. You can find those documents by entering the requisition number against which what sales order has been created. That you can see. Yesterday we have seen. Yesterday we saw that, right? Now, once the sales order has been created, it's as simple as normal sales order. Where I ship to location, internal customer. So there is an internal customer, ship to location Hyderabad. Then we have the lines, item, quantity, price. From Gujarat is the shipping organization. Then receiving organization is Hyderabad. Ship it. Against your shipment, they are going to perform receiving into the stock, Hyderabad. That's it. But the important point is, item should be internal ordered enabled. Then your internal customer should be defined having link to organization and respect to location. That is important setup that we saw yesterday, right? That's what the gist of yesterday's class. Now let us move on to the important topic. We are using sales orders, but every sales order will be having order type. What is that order type? So let us see now. I have the details. This is what we created yesterday. This is ISO. This is external sales order. This is external SO we created. This is external SO we created. And let us see. Let us see the external sales order first. So it's responsibility to order management. Orders. We are discussing setup. In the setup, we are going to have order types, how we are going to define, what is there in the sales order. Let us see first of all, in the sales order, what is there? This is the order. Take the order. Copy. Control C. Okay, now the order type is CFTR. Now this is the sales order. We have the line items. In the line items, I have seen the line type. What is the line type? This is line type. Copy that. And the sales order number is this one, right? This one. Starting with 100,000, 365 means 365 sales orders have been created by the time. Now we have taken the line type and order type. Now let us see. Setup. Transaction types. What is transaction type in order management? Means it is nothing but order type. In inventory, transaction type means your miscellaneous transaction, miscellaneous receipt, account alias receipt, miscellaneous issue, account alias issue, sub-inventory transfer, move order transfer, move order issue. All these are transaction types in inventory. Don't be confused. It is a very important question. What are transaction types in order management? Then you should not answer inventory answer. You should answer order management details like order types which will be used in the sales order and which will be having line type assigned to the order type. I'm going to show you. Now, sorry, we have order type, that is nothing but transaction type. Define. This is the form where we are going to define all these order types, line types and everything. This is the sequence of defining the order types. It's very important and very difficult task. You have to understand. Listen carefully. It is very, very important for interview point of view, and it is the main setup that you do in order management. Now, I have taken the details. This is the order type. This is the order type. SCAFTR is one of the order types. And standard line, order line is the line type which is coming by default for this order type, right? While creating sales order. Now let us see. And this is the number getting generated. For some sales orders, have you seen this? Internal sales order is getting starting with, you know, getting started with, it is 300,000. Whereas external sales orders started with 100,000. And earlier, some sales orders started with 15,496. Have you seen this? So, there is certain sequence numbering based on order type. How it has to be, let us see. Now, I have taken the order type. This is the order type. Copy. F11. Clear. Whenever you get a problem, clear. Now F11, Control V, Control F11. You have the order type. While defining the order type, you have to fill all these details. What is the name of the order type? Description. What kind of document it is? It's sales order? Yes. What is order category? Mixed. What is mixed? Interview question. Mixed order type is the type, is the sales order type, which will allow both sales at the same time returns. In the same sales order, if sales order is not closed, you can perform the return also. What are the item you shipped through the same sales order? Some of the lines are still open, not yet to be shipped. But before closing the sales order, we got the return from the customer. We have to take it back. How? Again, you have to create an RMA. That RMA can be created in the same sales order. Means in the same sales order, you can have another line attached with a negative quantity so that you can take the item quantity from the customer. Mixed category is nothing but the order type which will allow both sales and return in the same sales order. It is very important. This is fulfillment flow. What is the, you are creating order type, whereas transaction type code is order, not line. First, we are going to see the line type also. There you will understand what is the difference between order type and line type. But both will be defined in the same form. What is the difference that you are going to observe? Okay, now fulfillment flow is nothing but a workflow. There are different workflows. These are all workflows. See, one workflow suggests something which is generic, written with submit and approval. You would require approval. You will get a notification. You have to open the notification and click on approve. Then only you can proceed further. Okay, for return order, return with approval. All these things, return with approval, return with credit memo. See, generic with header level invoice interface. All these things. Line flow generic is generic one. It is very important question. What is the workflow you are going to follow in the order management for a standard sales order? Order flow generic. It is as per the client requirement. If a client requires approvals in the sales order, then you can go for the workflow which allows approvals as well. You get a notification, open the notification and approve it. Now, from this date it is effective. I don't want to see this order type, put end date. After that date, you can't see this in the list of values of order types. That's it. Now, remaining fields. This is header. This is line. In the main tab, have you got it? See, default return line type. Just now we have taken the line type. This is the standard order line type. Okay. This is also one line type which has been defined. We are going to see that. Before going to define order type, first you have to define line type, and that line type, if you want the default, then you have to link here standard order line type. Copy this because I'm going to see that. Similarly, we have another one line type to be defined for returns in the same sales order. I can use because it is mixed. In the same sales order, line type should be differentiated with a different return line type. So return for credit. Return for credit. Okay. This is what? Return for credit. Then default order line type is standard order line. That is the reason whatever the line you create by default, this is getting defaulted. And what is the price list getting defaulted? This is coming from here. We have only one price list has been defined in the system. The same price list you have to assign here so that it will be defaulted. So every time, have you observed while booking the sales order, there is a credit check hold has been applied? Have you remembered? If yes, because the moment you book the order, while ordering, we have initiated by having credit check rule, one credit check rule. Let us copy this, Control C. T That is a credit check rule. Okay, I'm going to show you that. So that is the reason. At the order booking itself, the credit has to be checked for the customer. Then you have to create a rule, credit check rule, when it has to be applied. And you have to apply at the time of ordering, that means booking, you have to paste here. If you don't want at the time of order booking, at the time of packing, means at the time of delivery, then you have to paste here. At the time of picking, it should be checking. No, if you want, the system should check for the credit check for this particular customer, then you have to paste here. At the time of shipping, if you want, you have to paste here. You have to paste here. That's it. Wherever you paste, at that point of time, system checks for credit. In case if the customer fails to satisfy the credit check, then hold will be applied. Then again, you have to release the hold. Depends upon the customer relation. Shipping. By default, which warehouse to be defaulted? If you want something, you have to enter this. Else, it will be blank. You are going to select manually. Which organization is going to ship the item? Okay. Remaining things are, you know, all are optional. It's up to you. Whenever fulfillment set is enabled, keep in mind. Whenever fulfillment set is enabled, what is the use of fulfillment set? It's a very important question. Simply, it is a one checkbox. What is fulfillment set? Now, it's a very important question. As long as you shipped all the items in the sales order, means all the lines got shipped, then only this is eligible for invoice. Means we want to bring a control over the order where you might be having multiple lines. Any item has been shipped, for that immediately auto invoice runs. But if you have fulfillment set, auto invoice will not run because there are remaining lines to be shipped. If you want to create one invoice for the entire sales order, then we are going to enable fulfillment set. So that what happens, you know, for all the lines, whether the fulfillment happened or not, system checks. When all the lines are satisfied with the fulfillment, then one invoice will be created for entire sales order. It's a very important question. What is the functionality of fulfillment set? Very important question. Fulfillment set enables the functionality to identify the lines to be invoiced at once. Now, auto schedule. If you enable, the moment you enter the order, book the order, scheduling happens automatically. Finance, very important. Invoice source. Have you observed while running manual auto invoice? I have shown you how to run auto invoice. While running the auto invoice, you have given the parameter invoice source as. This is what of the value you entered here, that should be given for that respective sales order which has used this order type. Then, this is receivable transaction type through which they are going to track what kind of sales it is and what kind of payments we received against which order type. This is for tracking purpose in AR module, receivables module. Whereas invoice should be happened with an invoice source of COM invoices. That is the reason whenever you run the manual auto invoice, it is asking for invoice source where you are entering the same value. Okay, now this is what order type you are going to define. But before that, if you want to link line type here, first of all, line type to be defined. So copy this. Go here. Go to here. F11. Give the line type. Order control V. First, we are going to define description. There is no description. Order category order. Have you observed here? Transaction type code is line. Transaction type code is line. Earlier it was order. Have you observed? That is very important. This is going to decide. This is line type. That is order type. Now, remaining things. Enforce price list. Enforce list price means whatever the price is there in the price list, that should be the price and nobody can edit that. When you check this, nobody can edit the price that has been defaulted in the sales order. In case if you uncheck, it will let you to change the price. You can change from 100 to 150, 1000 to 2000. You can change the price. If you enforce, whatever price is there in the price list that has been selected in the, this is what order type, it is going to be defaulted in the line. Similarly, order type also having the default price list. So from there, whatever the price that has to be defaulted, nobody can change further if you enforce it. If you uncheck this, then you can edit. Go to shipping. Warehouse, which warehouse to be defaulted in the sales order line in the shipping tab. If you want something, enter here. If you don't want, let us enter manually. Whenever I book the order, I'll go to shipping tab. I will enter the warehouse from where, which warehouse it has to be shipped. Then go to finance. Nothing, because remaining things are taken care at order header, that is order type. Now, once you define this, copy this name. Now query for, now define the new order type, that is order type. This is what SEAFTR. Right? Here assign line flows. Once you define this, all the tabs, go to assign line flows. Here you are going to select that order line type that you selected. That is how you are going to link. Otherwise, you cannot. Line flow generic. Like order flow generic. For line flow generic, this is our flow to be. You got it? You can have different line flows. So this workflow is different. This workflow is different. This workflow is different. How many workflows are different? You know, those many sales order line types to be entered here. How many line types are there? If you want to see, these are all line types written for one order type is written for written order type, line type, internal sales order line type. Okay. All these things are the standard order line type. Similarly, you can have many if you want. You have to link here. That's it. After that, validate workflow. Then only this order type and line type will be linked. So first you have to define the line type. What is the order category? What is the transaction type? Is it order or line? What is the flow? Order flow generic. For line, it is line flow generic. For order, it is order flow generic. Then we have negotiation workflow. If you have quotations. Quotations. If you have quotations, you have to select the this negotiation workflow is nothing but meant for quotations. There are many things we discussed. Main tab, shipping tab, finance tab. Main tab, we have credit check rule to be initiated at the time of ordering, not packing, not picking, not shipping. If you don't want here, if you enable here, picking, nothing, but at the time of delivery, packing, that's it. It will ask you, it will to pass the credit check. If customer fails, system puts hold. You have to release. How to release? From actions, release hold is the function we have to select. That's it. Line type to be defined. Take the line type, then define order type, fill all the tabs, then go to assign line flows. Select the line type that you want to assign. Process select, you have to select the process which is the workflow to be assigned to the line type. Then start date from when. That's it. Line type to be defined. Order type to be defined, assign line type to order type, then validate workflow. Over. Now take this order type. Copy. Close this. Now I'm going to set up. Setup. Next one. Very important. I told you. Have you observed here? This FTR, CFTR is order type. Creating order with a number that is starting with 100,000. How? Let us see. Go to setup. Documents. Define. Next categories. Next assign. Define. F11. What are the document types? Define means document sequences. It is document sequences. Have you observed? It's not document type. Define for which application? Order management. Order management. Whenever you are entering something in query mode, it has to be exactly entered. So caps O, order gap management. Control F11. See, for this kind of, this is one sequence, this is one sequence, there are multiple sequences have been generated. Starting for internal, starting with 20,000, but disabled, it's not no more active. Wherever there is no effective, there is no to date, that is only effective. It is disabled by March 18th. Before March 18th, it was used, but now, only wherever there is no date, end date. For internal new 300,000, that was the reason. If you see ISO starting with, this many orders created. There is a sequence, 300,000, 100,000 for, 100,000 for what? Domestic new, domestic orders. That is the name given. Similarly, what numbers to be followed for return? It should be this number. Okay, for packing slip, what is the number to be followed? So this is how. Now let us see. For RMA order, what is the number to be followed? But end date, that means RMA 1 is a new one, which is enabled 90,000. This is how you have to enable. Whenever you click this, message will be coming, a pop-up. Like whenever you order, create order and save the record, then you will get a pop-up saying that so and so number, order number has been generated. That is a number. If you enable this, the message will come. Otherwise, it won't come. But let us say, first you have to give a name, application from which date, to the which date, to what date. If you leave it blank, it is active. Automatic number to be generated, but the starting number should be 1 or 100,000 or 1,000 or 300,000, like that you have to give. Then close this. We have taken order type. What is the order type? SEAFTR. Okay, now next one is categories. Remember, the moment you create order type, system creates for that order type one category. System creates, not yours. You are not going to create, but you have to find that category which has been created. The moment you created order type, what category has been defined by the system automatically, that you have to identify. To identify that, you have to take the order type. Just now I have taken, that is SEA gap FTR. Now let us find the category. Let us find FT. Okay, now what is the name? I don't know the name, but definitely it will have the word that is there in the order type. What is the order type? C gap one space FTR in caps. Let us find that. Percentage caps SEA, there is a space. I don't know whether space is there or not. Then enter the percentage. FTR. Control F11. Have you observed? This is what? But our order type is SEA FTR only. With that, there will be an order, order category will be created. Okay, but have you seen this quotation? Somewhere there is a suffix quote. What does it mean? Means wherever there is no quote, that is nothing but order type category. Whereas quote, this is quote type category. System creates two lines for every one order type. The moment you create order type in the setups, transaction types, define, there you are going to give a name. With that name, when you validate workflow, system generates two categories. What are those? One is order category, another one is quote category with the same name will be existing as a part of sentence, total sentence. You have to find by percentage. So this is order, this is quotation. Why quotation is coming? If you select negotiation workflow, then quotation will be created. If you are not selecting negotiation workflow, then quotation will not be created. It will create only order category. That's it. We have order workflow and negotiation workflow. Have you seen this? You have seen, right? Just now I have shown you in the order type, we have negotiation workflow, order flow generic. Order flow generic is the order workflow. Whereas negotiation workflow, we didn't select, or we select something, then it will create that order type with quote. This is the name standardly. Standard, what is the name? Order type. This is order type. Quote will be hyphen quote will be created by the system. Now, take this category. Control C. What is the category? CFTR. What is the quote category? This is this. Okay, now done. Next one, assign. Very important task. You should not do any mistake here. Now, to create a sales order, these are the activities you should do first as a part of setup. Otherwise, your order management will not work at all. You cannot create a sales order. When there is no sales order, there is no order management at all. Now, F11. What is the application? Order management. It should be accurately entered. Okay, it is nothing but order management. Let us enter like this. I don't know whether space is there or not. Management, control F11. Okay, we entered only application. You have taken the category name, right? What is the category? This is the category. Let us search with that. F11. Control F11. There are two. SEA FTR. Why two are there? Let us see. It is disabled. Have you observed? The sequence domestic might be 5-digit number. I have been disabled. The document sequence I have shown you 18th March. Till 18th March, there was 5-digit number. After that, 18th March, from 19th March, they switched to domestic new, which was having 6 digits. 6 digits having a number of, what is the number? Starting number. The starting number was 100,001. right? So what is the name of the document sequence you define? Copy that and paste it here. Have you remember? Document sequence. This one. F11. Order management. Okay, domestic, disable, 18th March, it was 4 digit number, now domestic, okay, new, 100,001, that was the reason we got it. What number you got it? This is the number you got it. That means 360 orders have been created by the time. So this is the after defining, you have to find the categories. For those categories, you have to assign that sequence that you define to respective categories in the assignments for the application order management. Then only you can simply create sales order by using that order type. Whenever you create an order with selecting order type as SCFTR, then the number will be generated. This is what transaction types in order management. What is the procedure? Let me give the gist. Create line type. Then create order type. Assign line type in the order type. Create document sequence. Find out the document categories. Are you defining categories? No. The moment you define the order type, the categories will be defined by the system automatically. If you select negotiation workflow, two categories will be created by default. What are those? One is meant for order type, another one meant for negotiation workflow that you entered in the order type. Means quotation. For quotation, for sales order. For these two categories, what is the document sequence to be followed? If you want to follow same sequence for both quotation and order, take the document sequence that you defined here in the document sequences, okay? Whatever you defined in the document sequences, that you have to assign to the order type category, then negotiation category, quote category. If you assign the same document, whether you create quotation or sales order, same number will be generated. Same document sequence. It starts with 100,001. I hope you understood. This is what transaction types in order management. Okay, if you want quickly create, I won't discuss anything, just watch the screen. Quickly I create new order type, assign line type to order type, create the new document sequence, find out the categories, assign the sequence to the categories and create a sales order with my own sequence. Just watch. Transaction types, define, first I have to define line, very important question. How many sales order types are there? Only two. One is sales agreement, sales order. No need to know sales agreement, but you have to answer sales order and sales agreement. Okay. Category. Mixed? Yes, I want mixed. Transaction type code. Is it order or line? I want to define line first. Then order category. Is it order? Yes.
For line type, it should be written or order. Okay. So line type, for line return type, you have to define return line type separately. Okay. From this date. Now, price list to be followed. That is enforce. Yes, I want shipping. Which warehouse to be defaulted? I want one. If you don't want default and you are going to select for every time, it's up to you. Leave it blank. Or you select your default, you want Worcester? Yes, select. Anything else? Source type, is it in the line type also you want external or internal? Which one to be defaulted? Internal? Yes, select that. Okay. That's it. Go to finance. Anything you want to select? Invoice source. You want to select? Then okay. Select it. There is nothing wrong if you want to select. Save it. Take this name. Take this name to the notepad. Observe very carefully. That is line type. Now let us define order type. Okay, copy this. Document type, sales order. Category, mixed. What type of order? Yes, line already I defined. Fulfillment flow. See, is it, you know, fulfillment flow is, you know, has not been asked while defining the line type. It has been asked while defining the order type. You have to remember that. We are assigning the workflow to order type, not line type. Negotiation workflow, let us create. Okay, negotiation workflow, generic. Okay, earlier it was not there, but I want to. Because I want to create two categories by default by the system. I'm not going to create. I am creating only order type. Line type I define. Let me take all the info. That's it. Nothing else. What else? In the main tab. What you want? Yep. You want written line type? Anything you want to? Okay. Already written line type also you have to define. The way I define line type, you have to define. Okay. Now select that. If you want to default. Written line type to be defaulted for written for credit with. Then default line order line type is, see this one that is there. I want to select this. This one has to be defaulted. Now shipping. And you want something credit check rules to be not at the time of order. At the time of shipping I want. It's up to you. At the time of picking you want. It's up to you. I want at the time of shipping. Which credit rule? This is the credit check rule I want. Go to finance or shipping. Which warehouse to be defaulted? For entire order, Worcester, it's up to you. But it's not mandatory. Auto schedule, if you want. Fulfillments, if you want, it's up to you. Auto schedule you want, it's up to you again. Finance, invoice rule. I want this. Tap. Sorry, not invoice rule. Invoice source, right? It is okay. And what about the receiving receivable transaction type? You want something regular invoice, FTR? It's up to you. Whatever it is. Regular invoice, let us select. Save it. But have you assigned the line type? No. Let us go to assign line flow. Here line type will be visible. What is the line type? This is the first one, BA. Select. Process name. What is the workflow? Line flow generic. You have to find out. Where is that? Line flow generic. Where is that? Check it out. This one. These are all workflows. You know, the way you want. You can select as per the client requirement. Start date from today. Click OK. Save it. What is the order type? This is the order type. Copy this. Control C. This is line type. This is order type. Now go back. I want my own sequence. So I have to define document sequence. Go to setup. Documents. Define. Name. Okay. Application. Order management. Order. Okay. Now. Okay. Automatic. What is the number? I want. The number should be like this. 104. 612. 0001. Sorry. This is the first number to be generated. Whenever I use my own order type. Save it. Okay. This is for order types. Do you want the same sequence to be followed for quotation? It's up to you. Then don't define quotation sequence. Let us assign the same thing to quotation as well as sales order. Whether you create quotation or sales order for both the orders, for both quotation and sales order, the same number type will be generated. The first number will be this 10461200001. And the next two, next three, same number. Let us see. Copy the sequence. Control C. Track. What is sequence? The sequence is this. Now close this. Next one. Categories. Go to categories. I told you categories are you going to create? No. System is going to create. Then what is the category created by the system for the order type? This is order type. Let us see. Copy this. Find out F11. Give the name. Percentage. Let us find. Control F11. Got it? One is created for order type. Another one is created for quotation. Have you observed? I have not created. System has created. This is interview question. Are you going to create category? No. Then how it is getting created? That's it. The moment you create order type, assign line type, validate workflow, that's it. System is going to create two or one. One, yes, if you are not selecting negotiation workflow. Two, yes, if you select the negotiation workflow as well as order flow generic. That's it. This is for quote. This is for order. Take the categories. This is for quote. This is for order. Control C. Close this. Now assign. I want to assign now. Application. What is application? Order management. Category. What are the categories? Two. First one is quote. You want quote or order type? I want order type. What is the ledger? This is from a multi-arc structure. Business group. What is ledger? What is legal entity? What is operating unit? What is your inventory organization? What is your sub-inventory? What is the locator? From that you have to take. Method. Automatic I want. Assignment. Start date. From today. Then sequence. What sequence? What sequence? I want this sequence. Copy that. That's it. Then, fine. Now, I did for order type. What about quotation type? Yes, I want. Then, category. Category. What is category? Quote category is this, not that. Ledger, same. Automatic? Yes. Sequence? From today? Yes. Which sequence? Same? Yes. You want same or something else? Then you have to select, you have to define new sequence. Then assign it. I want same. Save it. Yes. Now, what is your order type? This is your order type. Right? Have you validated workflow? I don't know. If you have the doubt, let us do once again. Define F11. Query the order type. Control F11. Validate workflow. Request submitted. View request. Fine. Completed. Close it. Now let us create sales order. Sales order. Customer. First customer element let us take. The moment you select the customer from the customer master, order type, everything will be defaulted, but I want to change it now. What is the order type? This is the order type. I want to use this. Copy. Which has been defaulted because it has been assigned to this customer. So I want to change it. Change it. Okay. That's it. Anything else? Let us save it. Go to lines. The moment you go to lines, order number will be generated. Let us see what is the number generated. Come on. What happened? Success or fail? It should be success. Success too slow. That's it. Enter the lines, but already number generated. Have you observed? Got it? That's it. That's it for today. Thank you.